fellow Toastmasters and guests. It was an April afternoon, hot and humid as hell. The sun was shining in its full glory, and I was sweating profusely that day, waiting in my car for the traffic signal to turn green, for what seemed like an eternity. At a distance, I saw a young girl looking at me with a strange intensity. And then, she came running to me and said, "Chatter Chaudhary, welcome back to Earth." Chatter Chaudhary? I kindly took out a 10-rupee note and gave it to her, thinking that she was a gone hit. "Thank you, Chatterji," she said. "I'll buy chocolates and share with Supandi and Tintin." Oh, Supandi, Tintin, it's happening around me. And then, a female voice from behind the car congratulated me for giving the 10-rupee note to the girl. "Who are you?" I asked. "I'm your wife, Channi." Oh, what is happening around me? I was all lost, until a cursory glance at the mirror revealed a midgety-looking man with a red turban, white moustache, white shirt, and black pant. It was me! I had been miraculously metamorphosed into Chacha Chaudhary. The girl was Pinky, who was all excited to know about my trip to Jupiter to find a bride for Sabu. I was all amazed and wondering what's happening. And then there was a loud commotion as my cell phone started ringing. "Who's this?" I asked. "Chacha-ji, this is Dennis the Menace." "Oh, how are you, kid?" "Chacha-ji, I am in deep trouble."
"What's happened?" I asked.
"Chacha-ji, I had been to the jungle yesterday. There, I saw a big tiger sitting atop a tree, crouching, snarling at me. I thought it would jump and eat me."
"And then what happened?" I asked.
"Luckily, I had Shikari Shambhu with me. He had his pistol and shot the tiger dead."
"Wow. Then what's your problem, kid?" I asked.
"Ah, nothing. I just broke my father's new watch and he would be dead angry with me when he came to find out." I said boldly, "Son, have the courage to accept your problem and mistake in front of your father."
"Ah, Chatterji, isn't that straight out of Lage Raho Munna Bhai movie?" he said.
I said yes. But this time, I had lost all my sense of timelines and of virtuality versus reality. "You better get ready fast. The guests are about to arrive any moment," announced my wife Channi.
"What's the occasion?" I asked. "Come on, it's our 50th marriage anniversary. He-Man and Superman should be arriving any moment.
Batman, of course, has to attend to a plumber who has to fix the leaking pipe of his new house. But Garfield has said he would come. But being the lazy bum he is, I know he would not come. But Mickey and Minnie, Tom and Jerry, all are coming. You better get ready." I got ready. It would be the time of my life, I knew. And I had the time of my life. It was a great party. And then there was a deafening noise, the sound of a traffic constable, which blew my senses. He was trying to wake me up from my slumber, for the signal had turned green. He asked me to move forward, or else he was ready to give me a piece of his mind. Oh, I fled from that spot, and I started driving. How I wish that signal never turned green. How I wish I never came out of that world, the world of Mickey and Minnie and Tom and Jerry. Oh, what a world it was.